So welcome back. We are solving some of the numericals of orthography predictions. So we have solved our numerical wherein this kind of this object was given to us, and then we have drawn the front view and side view and the top view of this particular object, and these predictions are obtained over the xy line. So front view was above xy line and top view was below xy line, and the side view is on the right of the that particular front view, since it is a left hand side view. Now we will see this particular object. So for this object, now it is also being asked to draw the three views of this object, okay, by using the first angle Mitra projection. So let us decide that we are going to draw the front view from this direction, okay, top view from the top, means looking from the top, and this is the direction of viewing this for the side view. So when you look it from this side, your ray of sight will be passing through all these points, and you will find that you will get this particular height of this object which is visible to you in the front view, okay. So this height is visible to you, and this is nothing but the length of this object which will be visible to you. This is the length of this object which is visible to you in the front view. So we have to measure this length and this height and draw first of all the rectangle above the xy line to draw the front view. Now you will find out that after a certain height from the left end, this line is a continuous inclined line from this height to this way. Okay, so if you know this distance, you have to measure the distance of this from the bottom. Okay, that much distance you can draw it over here. Means like, let me draw this here. Suppose this is the height. So this dimension is drawn here, and this is the another dimension. Okay, so this you can draw initially, and now you will find out the difference angle between these two. This is the angle drawn. At the same time, you will find this is the position for this line. So this you will get a vertical line for this vertical line. So this particular block is completed. Now from the left hand side also, you will have the position from this line. So it will be here, like this it will be there. Okay, and now this slot here, so this line is already covered, this bottom line is also being covered, and top line is also being covered. Now only thing is that now this additional portion, extruded portion, whichever is there, for this we have to draw something over there. And now you will find out that you have to take the projections from this line, okay, so that we can draw it here. Now this line and this line is same parallel, okay. So above that line it is having certain distance, so for that actually we have to take the projection like this, and this much distance vertical will go whatever is here. So it is up to this point because projection is taken from this line, okay. So this is the height we will obtain, and now it is to be drawn horizontal one. So this way it will be drawn horizontal up to which point? So up to this point. So whatever this position line is taken from here, up to this we will draw horizontally, okay. So we will get this particular front view which will be viewed as this. As now it is position are taken over here up to this, but this particular slot is there up to the end of this particular side. So therefore you are, and this is not visible from this side, it is there but it's not visible, and for that you are drawing this dashed line, okay. Now when you see the side view, so you are looking from this side, okay, and your ray of sight will be passing from all these points like this. So initially you will get this line, so you can draw this line over there. Let's use another color for this. So this is the line we are drawing. Now actually this fully vertical line will be visible to you on this side, okay. So you can find here this complete line like this, okay, and this way it is visible from this side. This line is also completely visible. It means this first rectangle which is here in the blue color, that is completely visible to you. So you can draw that rectangle first like this. It will be a rectangle, and whatever this height of this particular object is there, so this object will be visible to you up to this point, and then from this point onwards it will be visible Okay, and if I take the position from this point, I can restrict its height like this. Okay, so this is also visible to me. So I will be just drawing the line downward. Okay, and if I take the position from this, so I will be getting that dimension. This way it is there, and this way it will be obtained. Okay, at the same time, this blue block which is visible to me on this side, so that is actually touching to this particular top point. So it will be drawn here only like this according to their dimensions. So in short, we will get this shadow like this. Okay, so what is the portion visible to you from this side of this blue color? So that is also drawn over here, and this slot is throughout up to the bottom, and therefore this dashed line is drawn there. Now similarly, we can draw the top view. So for drawing the top view, we are going to see from the top. So your ray of sight will be passing from all these different corner points, and whatever the top view you can see here, you will find out that this green color block will be visible to you. So this line is completely visible from the top. So let me draw this line. Okay, this line is completely visible. Another, this one line is also completely visible. Okay, this to this end. So these two lines are completely visible. Now this line is there also, it is having continuity with this line. So similarly, I will get this line also completely visible. Okay, and here only there is no continuity because the material is removed from this side. So it will be up to this point. It is moving inside by some distance. Then again it is coming like this. Then again it is coming out, and then it will be joined this way. So somewhat like this, you will get the view of it. At the same time, this pink color will be visible to you from the top. So for that, we'll be drawing this block. Okay. So what are the dimensions available with us? According to that dimensions, we have to draw that block. And this block is starting from this end. So another block will be there from that end point. So it will be drawn in this way. So in short, you will get the top view of this object, which will be somewhat like this. And this is what is drawn over there. Now these views we have to actually draw on x, y, and so this is just for understanding that how your front view and side view and the top view will look like. Now when actually you have to draw it over here, it means you are going to consider this x, y line as well as the x1, y1 line. Okay, as I told in the last presentation, we will be keeping some diamond side for the dimensions and for writing some letterings of the front view, top view, and side view. So we'll have to draw the line here parallel to XY line, top, above, and below, also towards right and towards left, okay, of this X1, Y1, and then whatever the block of the height and length that you will prepare here, in that actually you have to draw this front view, and what is the block that you will prepare for the top view with the length and the width. So by taking position from here for the length and marking width from the object, and then transferring these dimensions by using this front view and top view, so it will be transferred like this, and you will get the block for the side view also. Now in these blocks actually you have to make this construction whatever you have just now seen how I explained to be drawn. Okay, and then the first we'll draw the front view, which will look like this. Actually this is hidden line, this is dashed line. Okay, then we'll draw the top view of it. So front view first will complete, then we'll draw the top view, and then we'll take the positions using the front view and the top view to get the side view. So this is the way you will construct the front view, top view, and side view of this particular object. Okay, so now we will see one more problem. So this is nothing but the pictorial representation of an object given to us, and here also we are asked to find out the or to draw the three views of this object by using first angle method of projection. So we will be using this first angle method of projection, means drawing xy line and drawing the front view above the xy line, top view below the xy line, and left hand side view towards right of it. So this is the direction of viewing for the front view. So we have to see this object from this side. So your ray of sight will be passing like this, okay. And now you have to make the construction of this particular front view, whatever is visible to you. So you will find out that, so this blue color which is visible to you in the front, this is visible to you in the front, this wave will be visible to you in the front view. So these are the three things that is visible to you, and this V type shape. So in short, if I try to draw this, I will be getting this line and this line. So continuously this complete line will be visible to me, okay, while from the top I will be getting this line up to this end completely visible. So this way, then there will be a V shape. So from this side also it is visible here like this, okay. And for this also I will be drawing continuous vertical line downward this way, okay. And for bottom also it is completely visible line will be there, because from here to here it is with the rectangle visible, and here there is a slot, V slot, so that is also a complete visible line. This is also visible, so I will be drawing complete visible line like this. Now on the top side this V shape is there, so whatever dimensions are there of this V shape, we will be constructing this V shape like this, okay. And now this block is having certain height, so proportional to that dimension I will be drawing this horizontal line again, because I will find that this height and this is also continuous, so I will be getting that line continuously. Now here there is one edge, there is one more edge, and this is one edge at the center. So I will be getting three different edges here. So one this edge, this another edge, and this one more edge. So three vertical lines will be there on this. Now for this wave I will be getting one more vertical line like this, and for this wave I will be getting one more vertical line like this, okay. So this is what your front view will look like. So if I complete this view, it will be looking like this. Similarly, now if I have to draw the top view of this, looking on this side top, so this color, okay, which is yellow color, okay, that is visible from the top, as well as this wave will be visible to me from the top, and this is also visible to me from the top. So these are the shapes which are visible to me from the top side. So that is what I have to draw it. So these are the rays of sight looking from the top, which I have to pass from this. So if I have to draw the line for the top view, so I will be getting this line continuous, this line is also continuous, similarly here. So first let me draw this line which will be a continuous line. Now from here if I take, again it will be a continuous line, so I will be getting this line also continuous. Now if I see this side, so this is also continuously visible to me from the top, so I will be drawing for this line is also continuous. And now this line is up to this point it is visible to me, okay, this much point, whatever the distance is there. Similarly from this side, this much line is visible to me, so I will be drawing it from this side. Now there is a V shape over here, so that V shape will be drawn over here by using the dimension of the particular object. This way I will be drawing it, okay. Then this line is completely visible from the top, and this line and these lines, actually it is matching looking from the top. So I will be getting this line continuous this way, okay. So line for this first rectangle will be ending over here, and for this another rectangle its line also will be there, which will be drawn like this. And this slot its edge is there at the middle, so that edge is also visible like this. So this is what is nothing but the shape of this object. At the same time it is having the slot at the bottom, so that slot is not visible from the top, but it is there. So I will be drawing the two dashed lines for that particular slot according to the dimensions wherever it will come. So like this actually I have to draw the hidden lines actually. So in short, this view will look like this, okay. And that hidden portion of it is, suppose if it is matching with this line, if this dimension, then it will be exactly below this. And now on this side it will be completely visible, this dashed line, this way it will be there, okay. Similarly we have to obtain the side view of it, so looking from this side. So let us pass the first of all the ray of sight over it, and now whatever the shape which will be visible to me, so definitely this vertical line will be there, complete vertical line, this one. Now this line will be up to this end, and then it will be above by some distance, and then means you can draw this slot type observation. So it will be here like this, then it will go vertical, then it will be again like this, then again it will go downward and this way, this drawn. Now this height we can draw it here. So whatever this height is there, that will be drawn. Now from the left hand side, the distance of this line is to be constructed over here by taking the projection. Now this point I have, and this also point I have, means this one and this one. So I can join these two points by and current line. So it will be constructed like this. Okay. So now whatever is there, it will be everything will be behind this. So it means now this particular triangle, which is visible actually in the side view, but it is not completely visible from here. So it is there. So whatever the position of it, so I will draw that line as a hidden line here, from here to here. Okay, and then this horizontal line like this. This way it will be drawn. Okay, and this is what your side view will look like looking on this side. So actually hidden portion for this will be visible, means it will be there as a hidden line, as just now I have explained. So now these views actually we have to draw above the XY line, and the front view will be drawn like this initially. Then we can transfer these dimensions for getting the top view. So only length dimension we can transfer from here, and width dimension actually have to put it from the object. And now length, width and height, these all the three dimensions will be available with these two views. So we can transfer all these dimensions to get the side view, and the side view will look like this. Okay, so this is what is the construction of this. Now this V slot is also there. So this is the dashed line, hidden line for this particular V slot. And this triangle means a vertical line and horizontal line, it will be for this one. Okay, so in short, this front view, top view and side view of that particular object will be looking like this, and then we have to provide the dimensions to this particular object properly, okay, by using any one of the method of dimensioning. Okay, so we'll just stop here. Thank you. Thank you very much.